what a simple job he had to do for a friend. Basically what he wants is an 8th key we're putting down there. The problem I've got is if I mount the 8th cutter in there, by the time I bring it down I just haven't got enough depth, haven't got enough length. I will get enough depth using that AR32 hole, that to get his key weight into there, which will be enough. But I don't think this is very accurate. It's not exactly a precision one. It's got 5 thou run out, which is not accurate enough for what I need. I think the drill truck's actually better than that. This is one of the milling cutters Alan Booth sent us a couple of years ago. Obviously it's imperial, it's an 8th cutter, but it's also got an imperial shank, which is 3/8. I've got a 3/8 reamer here. I've got a nice steel out the inside of a car shock absorber. So all I'm going to do, I'm going to drill and ream the end of this and just make a little adapter so I can hold the collet, so I can hold the milling cutter into an R8 collet. I've got this run fairly accurate in a collet chuck. I'm just going to drill the end, set the drill the end, take one cut off there to make sure it's running dead true, then drill it and ream it. Quite tough, this material. Then the lubricant on with the reamer. Run it nice and slow. That's basically in the full depth. That's a lovely fit in there. Really lovely fit. Just going to chamfer this edge off, part it off, and then we're going to mount it in the mill and get on with the job we're going to do in the first place. A little countersink of that in as well. Job. Mate, we part it off, or we try to part it off. Since there's only a material this, I don't even know what it is. Just we face the end of that, put a little chamfer on and then it's good to go. I like using the collet chuck because it's accurate and it doesn't mark the job when you grip it. I've been wanting to make a collet chuck for this lathe for quite some time. I really need to get it done. This is quite tough material, this, it's not little grub screw in there that locks onto the flat on the milling cutter. And that's going to do, hopefully, just what I wanted it to do. It's quite an expensive looking part, so instead of doing it straight on there, I'm going to do a practice run on this bit of aluminium. The part's actually made out of aluminium as well. It's an 8th Kiwi I want. 8th's 125 thou, so half of that's, say, 65 thou. So we'll touch this off, probably take a 30 thou cut, just see how it works. I'm going to run the cutter as fast as it'll go and start it up. It's running nice and true anyway. And I don't know what that noise is, but I can't stop the bastard. Touch it off. Right, it's just touching there. And zero of the Z axis on the mill. Put on 30 thou. As I said, this milling cutter's only got one ambition in life, and that's to snap off. Right, we'll try the key in there, try the key in there and see what sort of fit we've got. That's pretty good. It'll certainly do the job. I would like it a little bit tighter, but there's nothing I can do about it. It's certainly not piss wobbly slack. Right. And this adapter will come in handy because I've got quite a few milling cutters with a 3/8 shank. It's important that the key slot goes right in the centre. I've got the camera at an angle, so hopefully you can see the wiggler here, and you can also see the DRO. I'd start it up. You see it pushes it, and it starts to push it square until you see no movement at all, and then square there, then it pushes off. We're going to zero the Z-axis at that, and I'm going to do it again. Right, we'll try zero on the right axis this time. And I'll do it again. Just pushed off there, and you can see that's deadly accurate. Right, so I set it zero. Little simple case. Look, I go round to the other side. Right, do the same on this side. Bring it in until it stops moving. Then pushes off. There. I've got a reading of 35.26. I'll do it again. Right, same reading, 35.26. So if I have 35.26, that's going to put that dead in the centre there. Right, so we need 17.63. 17.63. I'll lock the table up at that. What you'll find is that the reading will move very slightly as I lock the table up. Right, we've measured it and set it up. It does no harm at all to eyeball it just to make sure. Right, that should stop moving there. And if I weigh it out and I look along there where the camera's looking, that's absolutely blob on in the middle. If it looks right, it is right. But we've measured it and we know it's right. Measured twice, cut once, look three times. Right, we're ready to go for real now. Touch it off, just touch it there, view the z-axis, just the same as before, 35 foot, to finish it off. Right, that's a nice fit in there. It's not too shabby for a mechanic that pisses about. Once again, it's just time to say thanks very much for watching, subscribing, clicking the like button, buying a t-shirt if you bought a t-shirt, but a special and massive thanks to all the well witches that are coming in towards Deb and me dad and are still coming in. Thanks very much. Right, we've measured it and set it up. It does no harm at all to eyeball it just to make sure. You bastard, you. Twatting thing. The shank of this mill and cut has to your bell end. Oh, you twat. Bollocks, man.